Wait, electric cars on a car enthusiast channel, like slow Priuses and strange looking Honda Insights? Wrong. This is the Tesla Model S, and it's actually pretty freaking great. And as you can imagine, I'm about to tell you why. I'm Fuller, and I don't pop up on the Fitment Industries channel too often because I'm usually busy blabbling on about trucks over on Custom Offsets, but when there's something performance related happening with the dudes over at FI, I can never stay out of it. So when Tesla invited me down to the track to take the P100D Model S for a few laps, I saw an opportunity and I took it. So before we get too deep into this video, I'm just gonna start by saying this video is not sponsored by Tesla, they just gave me the car. So these are my actual opinions. Just so you understand what I'm talking about, the P in P100D stands for performance, the 100 is the kilowatt hours for the battery, and the D stands for dual motor, so this car is all-wheel drive. So some quick background on electric cars and why people seem to hate them. Electric cars have actually been around for much longer than you probably thought. The first one was actually developed in 1832. Yes, 1832. Of course, it didn't go well, and the internal combustion engine took the limelight until about 1970, when gas prices skyrocketed. The first electric car that actually gained some popularity was the EV1, which was produced by GM in 1996. The challenges then were pretty much the same as they are now: range, cost of battery technology, and the overwhelming fear of people who just don't think they can rely on battery power alone. So where Tesla is different is they set out to attempt to change the way the world travels, and they wanted to make a car that everyone could afford, but it's hard to mass produce a car that the masses don't want. The EVs from Honda and GM and the slew of one-time car manufacturers looked terrible, if I'm being honest, but the design has to do with aerodynamics and efficiency, so I get why they look so ugly. There's a good amount of people out there who know that Elon Musk is the CEO of Tesla, but not everyone knows that he got a lot of capital to get Tesla off the ground from co-founding PayPal, and he actually had a flamethrower business for a while, so that's kind of cool. But that's enough rambling. Let's look at this car and why I think it might just be the best car that I've ever driven. And for the reference, I've driven a lot of cars. The Model S P100D is by far the easiest supercar fast car to drive. Sure, it lacks the enjoyment of having a stick and changing gears, but there's 100% torque available 100% of the time, which means if you punch it for a 40 roll or you take off from a dig, the car is ridiculously fast. But straight line speed is one thing, taking on a track is a whole nother game. If you convert the battery power to horsey power, you're looking at over 600 horses and about 1,000 foot-pounds of torque. It's actually really difficult to measure because of how the power comes on. The car will actually spin its tires on the dyno. So all Teslas have a very low center of gravity because the entire floor is batteries. So keeping all this weight low allows the car to stay extremely planted in corners. When you do get a bit too aggressive on the not gas pedal, the traction control kicks in and straightens you out. The Tesla rep I was driving with actually told me it's near impossible to spin the car out, but I didn't have the balls to try that in front of him. The linear power of the Tesla is something that's difficult to describe. It's like having the power of a boosted car, but with no turbo lag and the ability to go from 0 RPM to 10,000 without ever touching any of the numbers in between. Honestly, one of these at your local autocross event would probably wipe away the competition. This car is also more technologically advanced than anything else on the road too. I mean, it can literally drive itself. The 17-inch display in the center of the dash is basically your command center where you control everything from air conditioning to the radio, suspension, and motor options. The Model S now comes standard on air rides, so you can adjust height on the fly, and it has GPS memory that will remember if you keep raising the car at a certain spot, say like a steep driveway, and from then on it'll just raise itself up automatically so you don't have to. Sitting in the cockpit of this car is basically like sitting at the helm of a spaceship and using the biggest iPad ever to control the entire thing. But can a car enthusiast own one? I think yes, but I also think if electric cars continue to gain in popularity, it'll change the way people build cars. The Air Ride's a great example. It's not the only car on the market that comes stock with Air Ride, but it definitely has a bigger range of motion than anything else I've ever seen. So instead of buying a kit to lower this car, you have to program it to go lower. You can put this thing on the ground if you know your way around the software. When new features come out, you don't have to go to the dealer and have them installed. Tesla will just send you an over-the-air update, and the car will just have it. Software updates can change how things physically work on the car, and that's just mind-blowing. When it comes to wheels and tires, Tesla will likely never tell you that you can, deviate from stock, but you can. We've done it, we've seen others do it, and Tesla uses the same bolt pattern as BMW, so there's plenty of options out there for wheels. But what you will never find for Tesla is a louder exhaust, so you can impress your friends at the Walmart meet hitting two-step, because it's silent. there is no exhaust. If you're more the road trip kind of person, you can still take one in a Tesla. This car gets about 335 miles to a charge, and a 20-minute stop at a supercharger will get you back up to about 80% of your range. So would you drive one? Have you driven one? What prevents you from owning one? Let us know in the comments below. Peace.